Welcome in lecture 6 of quantum mechanics module 3. This is the continuation lecture of last lecture in which I already discussed about Compton shift and Compton effect. In this lecture we will discuss about the kinetic energy of recoil electron and the direction of recoil electron. Let's start this equation we already derived in last lecture, equation 4 and 5. This equation comes out from the momentum of electron. When we apply the conservation of momentum in perpendicular and horizontal direction. So mv sin theta equal to h nu f upon c sin phi, and mv cos theta h nu I upon c h nu f upon c cos phi. We divide equation 4 by 5, so we calculate tan theta, the direction of electron, recoil electron. So tan theta equal to nu f sin phi minus nu I minus nu f cos phi. Nu I or nu f can be written as in terms of wavelength. So c upon nu lambda f sin phi, c upon lambda I minus c upon lambda f cos phi. We can multiply nu I nu f in upper and lower side, or we take a LCM in this equation. So tan theta lambda I sin phi upon lambda f minus lambda I cos phi, equation A. Now we put the value of lambda f from the Compton shift formula. So we know in last lecture we derived the Compton shift formula, lambda f minus lambda I equal to h upon m naught c 1 minus cos phi. Lambda f equal to lambda I plus h upon m naught c 1 minus cos phi. Put the value of lambda f in equation A. Putting the value of lambda A in equation A, so tan theta equal to lambda I sin phi, lambda I plus h upon m naught c, 1 minus cos phi minus lambda I cos phi. Now we all have this equation, only we are rearranging this equation or solve this equation. So if we take these two terms, lambda I can be common and 1 minus cos phi. Tan theta equal to lambda I sin phi, lambda I is common, 1 minus cos phi plus h upon m naught c, 1 minus cos phi. 1 minus cos phi is taken outside from these two terms because both terms contain 1 minus cos phi. So lambda I plus h upon m naught c, 1 minus cos phi. 1 minus cos phi can be written as 2 sin square phi by 2. Or tan theta equal to sin phi is also written as 2 sin phi by 2 cos phi by 2. So this square is cancelled out from sin square phi by 2, and 2 is also cancelled out. A lambda I is also cancelled. We take lambda I common in this equation. So tan theta equal to cos upon sin is cot. So cot phi by 2, 1 plus h. Lambda is can be written in terms of frequency, nu f upon c square, c and c become c square, m naught. So tan theta is this. Or we can write, let alpha equal to h nu I upon m naught c square. So tan theta equal to cot phi 1 plus lambda square. From above expression it is clear that angle of recoil electron depends on phi. Theta is depend on phi. As phi changes, theta is changes. If phi equal to 0 degree, then theta equal to 90 degree. Okay. If phi equal to 180 degree, then phi by 2 is 90 degree and theta equal to 0 degree. It shows that only electron can recoil only in onward direction at angle less than 90 degree, while photon can scatter in any direction from 0 to 180 degree. Okay. So kinetic, how we calculate the kinetic energy? Gain in kinetic energy is how much energy of incident photon gives to electron. So since incident photon gives a part of its kinetic energy to striking electrons, then it gets scattered. The kinetic energy of electron is difference between energy of incident scattered photon, that is kinetic energy equal to h nu I minus h nu f. Change in photon energy is equal to kinetic energy of electron. So from companionship formula we calculate the value of mu f. Delta lambda equal to h upon m naught c1 minus cos phi, or lambda f minus lambda I equal to h upon m naught c1 minus cos phi, or lambda can be written as in terms of frequency c upon nu f minus c upon nu I equal to h upon m naught c2. This term is 2 sine square phi by 2, and c also come in this side. So 1 upon nu f equal to 1 upon nu I plus h upon m naught c 2 sine square phi by 2, or nu f equal to we take the LCM of nu I. Now this calculation is different for different user. If you try differently you can calculate, but last answer is same for all. So 1 upon nu f equal to 1 plus this term is also we consider as a alpha 2 sine square phi by 2 upon nu I, or nu f equal to nu I upon 1 plus alpha 2 sine square phi by 2. Put the value of nu f in equation 1. So k equal to h nu I minus h nu I 1 plus alpha 2 sine square phi by 2. Take h nu is common. So 1 plus 2 alpha sine square phi by 2 minus 1, and take the LCM of 2, 1 plus 2 alpha sine square alpha phi by 2, cancel 1 to 1. Then this equation become as k equal to h nu I 2 alpha sine square phi by 2, 1 plus 2 alpha sine square phi by 2, or k equal to 2 h nu I alpha sine square alpha phi by 2 1 plus upon 1 plus 2 alpha sine square phi by 2. This kinetic energy of recoil electron depend the scattering angle phi. Kinetic energy is also depend on the scattering angle of photon phi. So kinetic energy of recoil electron should be maximum when phi by 2 is 1. If this value gives the 1 value, then this kinetic energy is maximum value. Phi by 2 equal to pi by 2, or phi equal to pi. For maximum kinetic energy, photon should be scattered in own direction in from which is incident. Okay, so kinetic, that is 180 degree, or it return back to same direction. Kinetic energy equal to 2 h nu I alpha upon 1 plus 2 alpha. Put the value of alpha h nu I upon m naught c square. This equation become as kinetic energy 2 h square nu I square m naught c square 1 plus 2 h nu I upon m naught c square. This is required expression for maximum kinetic energy. This expression is for maximum kinetic energy, and this is general expression for kinetic energy. This is general expression of kinetic energy, and this is maximum expression for maximum kinetic energy. Compton effect is not observed with visible light. As we know, for maximum change in wavelength is delta maximum equal to 2 h m naught c. That is 0.0484 angstrom, or approximately equal to 0.05 angstrom. Maximum wavelength change is 0.05 angstrom. If we take wavelength lambda equal to 5 angstrom, then this change is for this is only 1%. If we take wavelength 1 angstrom, then change is only 5%. This change 0.05% is 5% of this wavelength. Now for visible light, visible light is 5000 angstrom. It is this change means 0.05 angstrom for this wavelength is 0.01%. which is almost undetectable and cannot be measured by any instrument, this change. So Compton effect cannot be detected for visible light. Here Compton effect is end, and this module is also ended. Some numerical problems we will discuss in next video lecture. For now, thank you.